So for the next example, what we're going to do is subtract two vectors. And I decided to switch them up. So this is b minus a. Vector b minus vector a. Now, the trick here is how we actually learned how to add and subtract integers. B minus a is actually b plus negative a. But what's a negative vector? Well, if we think about what the negative sign is, it's actually the opposite. Okay, so what is the opposite of vector a? The opposite of vector a is not opposite in magnitude, because magnitude is just distance. 40 newtons in this case, or a force, 40 newtons is 40 newtons. But the direction is where we go opposite. So instead of north, the opposite of north is south. The opposite of east is west. So instead of 30 degrees north of east, I'm going to go 30 degrees south of west. And that opposite is exactly 180 degrees. So north of east is in this direction, south of west is in that direction, and there's my 180 degrees opposite direction. That's actually how you subtract vectors. It's the first vector plus the opposite direction with the second vector. So let's actually now go and start with our vectors. But we always worry about the order. We're going to do B first this time, then we're going to do A. So I have my origin to start. And this is so much easier when you have graph paper, because then you can just start from your origin. You can actually draw the axis out. We start with vector B. Vector B is going to go north of west. With graph paper, you can start in the middle. I'm going to start over here a little bit to the right, so I know I have enough room. So I need to go 50 degrees north of west. I need to go 20 centimeters. So line it up. Label it. Labeled my angle, labeled my vector, so I started with B. Now, again, like we did with A plus B, we're going to draw our little axis right here at the end. And from that point, we're going to go 30 degrees south of west. So, because I'm looking to the west, and I'm looking at 30 degrees below that point. There's my 30 degree mark. And now I need to go 40 centimeters for my 40 newtons. This time I'm just going to come this way. Get it lined up. Oh, there we go. Overshot a little bit. And there's my two vectors. There's my 30 degrees, vector A, vector B, 20 degrees. And again, I have a resultant. And my resultant is from the origin of the first vector to the end of the second vector. And that's my resultant. Now, again, to end the problem, I need to have two things about vector r. I need to have distance, I need to have direction. So, measuring the distance, four 47.5. Newtons. Okay, 47.5 centimeters, but each centimeter is a newton. You can have my answer back on my original units. 47.5 newtons. Now the angle. I get 9 degrees. So this angle right here, and it's hard to label this, 9 degrees south of west. Don't forget, this lab is about measuring these things, not calculating them. It's measuring the distance with a ruler, measuring the angle with a protractor. Trigonometry will not help us. I'll remind you at the end. This is how we subtract two vectors by turning it into an addition problem.